Good morning, student. Today we have to see the problem solving and decision making. The problem solving is important both to individuals and organizations because it enables to exert control over environment. The problem solving gives us a mechanism for identifying these things, figuring out why they are broken, and determines a course of action to fix them. How to solve the problems? First one is, first ask ourselves, is there really a problem? Second, accept it. Third point is, ask for help. Fourth is, use 80% of our time to find solutions. Then next one is, the break the problems down into a smaller pieces. And last one is, find the opportunities. Then decision making. How to improve decision making? Some skills related to decision making are as follows. First one is, achieve listening, interpersonal skills, collaborations, communications, logic, problem solving, critical thinking, time management. The decision making is a cognitive process that helps you map out the consequence of our actions. It allows you to reach the best course of action that will help you achieve our goals and objectives. Second point is the self-esteem. The term self-esteem is used to describe a person's overall sense of self-worth or personal value. How to improve self-esteem? There are some powerful ways to improve our self-esteem are as follows. First one is, the master a new skill, do something creative, get clear on our values, challenge our limiting beliefs, stand at edge of our comfort zone, help someone, and last one is, heal our past. Then we see the life goals. Goals help you to determine priorities and direct you to focus on what is important. How to set our goals? First one is the decide goals. Write it down. Plan our first steps. Keep going. Celebrate. Then next point is the trace and time management. Stress is a common occurrence in today's life. There will always be a many things to do and never enough time. Stress is how our body responds naturally to challenges. A certain amount of stress is inevitable and is a useful part of life. In an academic settings, a healthy amount of stress motivates students to work hard, be focused, and return to students rather than doing something else. Some tips to reduce stress and improve the time management. First one is, the set our goals. When you set our goals, you can start working on our time. This will keep you focused and motivated. Then second point is, plan our day. Prepare our timetable and put the most important task at the top. Third one is, the take short break. These help you to relax and concentrate longer time. And last one is, the sleep for 7-8 hours at night. Lack of sleep may give rise many mental and physical problems, which may result in increase of stress. So sleep is essential stress management. Thank you.